Let's talk about why sine of negative theta is equal to negative sine theta. So it looks like we just put a negative on the outside. Is that also the case for cosine of negative theta and also tangent of negative theta? Well, we'll talk about those later on. Let's focus on this right here first. Right here, we can use the unit circle to explain it. So let's take a look right here. Here is our unit circle, like this. And let's just have a theta somewhere. Let's say here is my angle theta. And notice this is my positive angle theta. All right, this is the unit circle. So here is 1. Now, on the unit circle, the x is the cosine value. So this is cosine theta. And the y is the sine value. All right, x is cosine, y is sine. Okay, let's have a look. This is what we have so far, but we're trying to understand what is going on with sine of negative theta. So going this much right here is positive angle theta. Negative theta is just the other way around. So it'd be like this, right? Like this. Same angle, but the other direction, and that's negative theta here. And then you can kind of draw this right here as well, and you have this point. So right here, you can see that cosine of negative theta, it's the x value. And then sine of negative theta is the y value here. All right? But now, have a look right here. This much is positive because it's above the x-axis. Yeah? And if you go down instead, we'll get to this point. So in fact, this much is positive y value. This much is just negative y value. So sine of negative theta, when we have a negative here, it's really just the same as putting the negative on the outside and then sine theta. And this is from the original. And have a look. With this picture, we can also talk about cosine theta and also this. We are talking about the same x value from here to here. When we do the reflection, does the x value change? No, it doesn't. So that's cosine of theta, and negative theta here is still the same x value. So this, the negative doesn't matter. So that's the same as cosine theta, comma, negative sine theta. So this is equivalent to that. So as you can see, sine of negative theta is this. And in the meantime, I can also tell you cosine of negative theta. In fact, the negative doesn't matter. We just get cosine of theta back. And in fact, theta can be anywhere if you put the theta all the way from here to here, and then when you have a negative version, you go the other way. It's an up and down reflection. It's the same idea. So this picture works for all angles. Okay? And now here are two terms that you really have to know. So let me write it down right here for you guys. So suppose we have a function f. If you have f of negative x, if you can put a negative on the outside and then the original function back. If this is true for all x, then we call this function an odd function. And on the other hand, if we have f of negative x, if the negative doesn't matter, just like the cosine here, if we just get f of x back, if this is true for all x, then we call this an even function. So as you can see, sine is an odd function, and cosine is an even function because they have these properties. And now you might be wondering, odd is like odd numbers like 1, 3, 5, 17. Even is like even numbers 0, 2, 72, things like that. I don't see any numbers here. Why are they called the odd and even functions? Well, unfortunately, I cannot answer that question at the moment, because you have to wait until calculus in order to see that. And I would like to give you another example for an odd function. Let's say if we have x to the third power. When you have a power that's odd, yeah, that makes perfect sense. It's the odd function. It's odd because this f of negative x, you put negative x into x right here, and then to the third power. Negative 1 to the third power is still negative, and x to the third power, well, this is the negative on the outside, and then we get back the original. So as you can see, when you have an odd power, this right here will be like this. So it makes perfect sense. But for sine, I will tell you though, if you later on, once you encounter the power series in calculus, then go back to this video, then you'll see that sine, the power series expansion, they all have odd powers. And for even function, that's just cosine, I'll give you another example. Let's say if you have x to the fourth power, it's even because you not only the even power, but really when you do this, negative x to the fourth power, negative 1 to the fourth power is just 1, so you get the original function back. That's why it's an even function. Yeah? And then the power series for cosine, they all have even exponents. Alright, that said, here's a question for you guys. Is tangent even or odd? Alright, leave a comment down below and let me know what the answer is to this.